Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with today's edition of Canadian Stock Market Trends for Friday, May 2nd, 2014. Things are fairly quiet in the pre-market this morning. There are employment numbers coming out at 8:30 this morning that could spark some volatility and give some direction to the market, but so far things are fairly quiet. Now, if you were with us yesterday, we talked about the sell in May, go away strategy, and we looked at this chart, which shows the results of the S&P 500 since 1950. If you look at the results, if you only held the S&P 500 during the months from November to April, and you were to exit your positions at the 1st of May, you can see that the majority of gains over the past, since 1950, have been made during the November-April timeframe. And if you look at the results, if you only bought it May 1st and held it to the end of October, you can see that you barely had any gains at all over that time period. Now, today I want to drill in a little more, and this is a chart from Schaefer's Research, and they're looking at the seasonal tendencies if you only look at the second year of a presidential cycle. And so we have that traditional weakness through the summer, through the May to October timeframe, and it's on average down about 5% during that period. Now notice that we get some weakness into the summer, then we get a nice summer rally, and then you get a seasonal tendency into weakness in September, October, and of course we've had a few crashes during that time period. Now, when it's all said and done, the year usually ends on a positive note, on average up about 6% on the year. So you usually get a great rally into the end of the year. And so that's just something to keep in mind. It doesn't always work out this way, but that is what the market is used to. That is what a lot of people are expecting. And sometimes people get what they expect. Let's start off this morning looking at commodity prices, and we saw weakness across the board yesterday. All the metals were down, copper, gold, and silver making a new low for this move. We saw crude oil, gasoline, heating oil all lower, and natural gas slightly lower, still closing at the upper trend line on Thursday. Next up, let's take a look at our daily index charts. And when we start off looking at the pieces of the puzzle, it's not a pretty picture. Yes, we've got the Dow and the S&P 500 up near all-time highs. That looks great on the surface. When we dig a little deeper, the VIX is not making all-time lows, and we haven't taken out the previous week's low, and of course we haven't taken out the April low. So options traders in Chicago, not overly bullish on the stock market. If they were, then they'd be selling off the VIX. They wouldn't be buying as much insurance as they're buying on their portfolios, and so we'd see the VIX at least trending lower. The fact that it's not making all-time lows in sync with the S&P 500 is one thing. The second thing is the fact that it's not actually trending. So that's a bit of a concern. Now, the NASDAQ has come back over the past few days and is above the upper trend line once again, which is bullish for the overall health of the stock market. We still haven't taken out the previous week's high, so we'll have to see if we can do that on Friday. Now, big red flag, bond prices. Bond prices have had two great days in a row. Last time we had a bond buy signal in the bond market was back here, and so we've been on a buy signal for a few weeks now. We've taken out the previous highs, so people are rushing back into the bond market, paying higher prices for these bonds, which pay really nothing as a return, an overall return. And so my question is, why, if the stock market's so healthy and attractive, why are people hiding in the bond market? So that's a red flag. The other red flag, of course, is the Japanese yen. We were looking for it to trend lower. It is treading water at the moment, inside day yesterday. So that's not healthy for the stock market. U.S. dollar was up slightly yesterday, still on a sell signal. Canadian dollar still on a buy signal. The TSX still looking very healthy. No change there. A little weakness in the energy sector on Thursday, but still on a buy signal. Bearish reversal day yesterday for the financial services after making a new high. Gold stocks, the TSX Gold Index closed just below the lower channel line, generating a new sell signal. So that's unfortunate. So check your ETFs if you're playing the ETFs on that sector. Fertilizer stocks reversed yesterday. Both Agrium and Potash are still on buy signals. No change there. Income trust treading water at the moment. We had a little pullback in industrials. Infotech had a nice day yesterday. Inside day for materials, metals, and mining taking out the previous high there. So that sector is doing fine. Copper stocks pull back there, still on a buy signal. Silver stocks, fairly quiet day yesterday. Telecom stocks, the other day I mentioned telecom stocks might be the next ones to generate a weekly sell signal. And then, of course, the next 2 days that after I say that, the telecom stocks are up. So no weekly sell signal this week. And the venture exchange in the channel at the moment, still on a sell signal, no change there. Next up, let's take a look at some of the TSX most actively traded stocks. Starting off with Bombardier. Bombardier had a great move on Wednesday, pushed up through the previous highs. Thursday, unfortunately, it had a big pullback, and we actually traded through the lower channel line, but closed at the upper channel line. So on Friday, we're looking for a close below 406. Now, if you were watching the stock and last week you were looking up, you would have seen that our next target was 430. And so if you took the buy signal, you would have put in an order to sell part of your position at the 430 level. Of course, if we take out 430 close above it, then we're looking for 469. So what happened? We did close through 430 and quickly reversed on Thursday. So you got some orders filled at 430. We are still on a buy signal, so that 469 level is still in play. If we close below 406 on Friday, it's all over and we're back on a sell signal. Looking at the fertilizer stocks, both Agrium and Potash, still on buy signals, no change there. Looking at BlackBerry, fourth day of a buy signal here, traded through the first target, looking for a move up to 938, and that looks certainly possible with the pros just about to take control. You can see it's been fairly calm, cool, and collected the last month or so with the pros and the public, and the pros took control a couple times over the past couple of months and gave up fairly quickly, so this looks like the time and place where we could thrust higher. The CGI group has had a nice run over the past few weeks, inside day yesterday with a little pullback. So it certainly looks like the Obamacare fiasco has not done long-term damage to this stock. Barrick Gold made a lower low yesterday, so that's not it's not a good sign for the gold sector. Agnico Eagle still on a buy signal, one of the few gold stocks that generated a buy signal on this move. We saw Cenovus pull back yesterday, generate a sell signal. Inside day for Husky on Thursday. We saw Imperial Oil pull back into the channel, while Suncor Energy closed higher yesterday, so up at those recent highs. We had an inside day yesterday for Thomson Reuters. We talked about this stock the other day on the Ion Equities presentation, and what we were looking at is the fact that we ran up and filled the open gap and then started to pull back. So if you are using our charts, you've had two chances to take money off the table here. If we can take out and close above this week's high, then 40.63 is our next target to the upside. But it looks like all they wanted to do was run up and fill that open gap, and that might be all she wrote. Looking at Canadian National, still on a buy signal. Canadian Pacific came down hard on Tuesday, but did not close below the lower channel line. So Thursday and Friday, we moved back up to those previous levels. So no change there. Let's finish off this morning's presentation with a quick look at a couple of 60-minute charts. We've got the TSX up at the top of the panic zones there. We're still projecting higher, had an early warning signal yesterday afternoon. If you look at the recent price action, we came down and found support at the 100-hour moving average. That's the 50, the 100, and the 200-hour moving average. Found support at the 100-hour moving average. I'm still projecting higher prices here, so no major damage done yesterday. We found resistance at 14,687.50. If we can break out above that on Friday, then look two lines up, and that would give you our next trading range. If we start trading below 14,609, then look down two lines, and that's our next trading range, which would take us back down to the recent low. And of course, if we take out that recent low, that would be a tell, and we'd be working our way closer to a daily sell signal. So on Friday, we want to remain bullish on the Canadian stock market, even though it sort of limped along in the afternoon yesterday. We want to remain bullish until we see an hourly close below 14,000. 636. An hourly close below that point would give us a new intraday sell signal on Friday. Okay, folks, thank you very much for your time and attention. It's much appreciated, and we do appreciate all your feedback and support. Have a great day, have a great weekend, and we'll talk to you again next week.